In this video, let's look at the three laws of test-driven development. Hello, I'm John Reed with qualitycoding.org. In this training, I want to take our test-driven development to the next level. You may already be familiar with the three steps of test-driven development: red-green refactor, which looks like a dance step, that's why I call it the Tdd Waltz. So there are also three laws of test-driven development, which operate at an even lower level than the three steps. In fact, you can go through the three laws while working on step one, making a successful failing test. So let's look at an example of that. And you're going to be my pair. So it's your job to catch me when I violate any of the three laws of test-driven development. What are those three laws? Law number one says that you can't make production code without first making test code for it. Law number two says you can't write any more test code than is sufficient to fail. And not compiling is also a failure. And law number three says you can't write any more production code than is necessary to make the currently failing test pass. All right, so brace yourself. Let's look at an example in Swift. It also has a mock object as a bonus. In the Marvel browser sample app, I'm making a network request object. Its job is to manage a URL session task. So as you can see, it has a start method, which makes sure that there's no current task, and then remembers the task as the current task, and then starts it with the resume call. What we want to TDD is a cancel method. All right, ready? Let's go. Ready, my pairing buddy? So we want to start with a cancel method, right? So I'm going to do cancel like that, and oh, wow. What's wrong? Oh, I'm violating the first law of test-driven development. That is, I shouldn't be making production code. Not without a test. Okay. Let's back out. And let's go over then to the test code. So we already have a test suite for this class, which sets up the SUT, the system under test, as the network request. It even has a mock task all ready to go. So let's go down. Okay, so now let's add a new test. And this will be cancel with existing task should cancel current task. All right, and first we'll set up the precondition that there is an existing task, and then we're going to cancel it. And the results of that are that I want to assert something. Oh, I'm violating the second law? The second law says that I can't write any more test code than is sufficient to fail, and not compiling is a failure. You're telling me this doesn't compile. All right, let's see. Oh yeah, all right. So at this point, that's enough. We stop. And we go now to the production code. And here under the handy light bulb, or press Option Enter, is the create method. And so now we want to take the current task and... What? Oh! I'm violating the third law, which is that I can't write any more production code than is sufficient to pass the currently failing, the current failure. Right? So now we come back here, and this should build. I'll go ahead and run them. There's no assertion, so I'm not expecting anything to change. Building should be enough, but yeah, there it is. Okay. Okay, so now we want to add some sort of assertion. I want to say verify on the mock task, verify cancel, whatever that looks like. I don't quite know what that is. Let's see if we can create that. Well, let's just copy and paste this, and this is going to be not the resume call count, but the cancel call count. All right, and so now we're going to make a property for this. This is going to be a var. Is that hopefully enough to fail? Let's try it and see. Oh, I need to pass in the file and line. And good. We get the expected failure. How am I going to get this to pass? How is this verify going to be satisfied? It's going to be satisfied when the call count goes up. Well, let's see what this is going to look like. So if we come to the production code and I try to say task cancel, I can't. Why? Because task is this protocol, which is actually a slice of the full URL session task. So this is using the interface segregation principle to take just a slice so that we can mock it. So let's jump in here and find cancel. There it is. Copy that and paste it into the protocol, remove the open. Now I should start to get some failures, I think. The production code is fine because the URL session task, because we copied this method, the signature from its overall method signature or class signature, the protocol already is satisfied. But the test code will now fail. Okay, so now we have enough of a failure. Let's go over here and say, I'm going to implement cancel and say cancel call count should be 1. Now I still expect this to fail. We're just building up the test, the mock object here. All right, so back here now, I should be able to take the current task, which is an optional, and there, call cancel on it. I expect this to pass. Hooray! Test-driven development is the art of creating production code and test code simultaneously. But because there are two things in play, what the three laws of TDD do is they constrain us to change one thing at a time. So we change test code, production code, test code, production code, and it's like we're walking, keeping one foot on the ground at all times instead of jumping and losing control. So you see that it even caught me in an error. At one point, I made a mistake with the test code, and because I hadn't gone and changed the production code at the same time, I knew where the problem was. It was in the place that I was last touching, and I could just go quickly fix it up and continue on my way. So that's TDD. If you'd like me to come out and teach a TDD workshop to your iOS team, please click this link here and to learn more about my workshop. And if you have any questions or thoughts that you'd like to share, leave a comment below. Thanks for watching.